Andrew McCart, IFL TV in association with MTK.
Well, nice to meet you, Pat.
Nice to meet you, brother. MTK Global, we're in Glasgow, Emirates Arena, with me up with Stephen Ormond. I must say, Stephen, that was fun to watch. Was it fun being in there?
Yeah, I'd rather watch it. No, I loved it. Do you know what? Just everything, all the decisions up and down, and I just knew it was my time. I had to be my time in the strike. Dig deep. I knew he was great, he's good ranking. Ghana, Angra, I knew it, and he's, MTK signed him, so I knew he was like, he's going. Do you want him for a world title shot? But he said something in an interview saying he's going to use me a step. So little did he know, like, I was prepared like, for this fella. I took his ranking. But it was a good fight. He was strong, but dug deep, you know.
It did prove to be a tough fight. I mean, you touched on it there. Both of you touched the canvas.
Yeah.
Did any moment of that fight you think, oh,
no,
God.
No, do you know what? I tell you, when that happened to me, I says, fuck this, is this. Excuse me, right? Fuck this, is, let's go. Just woke me up.
Yeah,
I know usually you go on the back post now, but I should have stayed inside him, giving him room all the time, because even if he's throwing these long shots, you're bleeding strong, you know.
Mm-hmm.
But when it passes, stay inside him. He didn't know what to do inside. I said, I'm working inside. He was like, he kept asking the referee to pull us off, so I should have done that early on. But
again, you said you should have done that early on, so that wasn't the game plan going in, because later around you were sitting on this chest, yeah, letting the body go, and was that just a change of game plan?
Yeah, I just realised he didn't know how to walk inside. He was like, God, power, long shots. But when I went inside him, he didn't know what to do. Do you know what I mean? When I moved on a bit, when he hit me the long shots, you could feel him. So I started staying on him. Just tap. When I was throwing that stupid left hook off top, I was passed. Don't be throwing that shot, because I don't miss it. He swing that leading right hand, the hammer his, you know. But I'm all ahead, and I woke me up.
So you didn't enjoy the fight then?
I did anyway.
Yeah, you didn't
know. No, it was a good, it was a ranking fight. I needed that fight, so I put everything into it.
On you go.
I put everything into every camp, but now I'm just, I know I keep saying, but I feel I'm really, all the bad luck and all, it's torn all around now. So, on the opportunities to get MTK, they gave me all the opportunities and they are great, me, do you know what I mean? So, they got me this fight again, and I'm delighted.
We said the opportunities, you said you took his rank in the WBO at lightweight. Yeah. I take it you've got one eye on the Ray Beltran.
Yeah.
Who knows, like a couple of another good wins against ranked opponents, and you could be.
I love now fighting now for a title in the WBO. Because I've got a good name then, I've been highly ranked before WBO. And I love it to turn any route, but like now because I got his ranking, let's go down that route.
So when you looking at the Ray Beltran against Pedroza?
Pedroza.
I take it you've got one eye on that fight, and if you do, what's
fight.
Your thoughts?
Me and Beltran would be great fight.
Yeah, I know.
Action fight, you know.
Did you watch his fight against Ricky Burns?
I did. I think I fought in the character. No, I didn't fight in that one. I fought in a lot of Ricky's fights.
Yeah.
But it was some fight as well. Ricky's a warrior, you know. But I watch it. And he's a good guy, isn't he? So, like, mm-hmm. Good fight as well. Listen, the winner.
You mentioned MTK that they're doing wonders with you. So, a couple more decent wins under your belt against ranked opponents, you could possibly, if Ray Beltran comes through his fight, do you think that's a possible fight in the future?
Yeah, why not? Like, MTK, like, as I say, I'm with them now. You're not the B fighter, you're the A fighter. They look at all the fighters. Even when I had losses, the things don't me. Mm-hmm. Next, say, you okay? You know, that just made me, because he had a good team behind me. Then me coaching on Pascal on my corner. And then I'm living, training real good, and I'm happy in there. Mm. Smiling every round. I just loved it. I love that. I have that love back with it. And I'm a bit mad, so.
No.
That helps.
There you go, you're a bit mad, mate. Again, I'm going to touch back on it there. But you said you took his rank, and you're obviously not going to jump straight into a world title fight and whatnot. So there's people ahead of you.
Nah, no, no. Wait, don't get me wrong. If the lightning struck fucking twice, I'd go for it.
Yeah,
but, no, listen, we'll say like that. Why don't
I? Know.
It was a great win for me anyway. That's
really. It's a great win for you. But what I'm saying is, looking at the rankings, is anyone in there that you would like to face to maybe get you that step?
I don't even know who's in the rankings, to be honest. I just know Belgium's champion, but every fight's a hard fight, especially with me.
Well, there you go.
Well, don't make them easy, will we? But no, with that guy there, anybody in the world would be worried for him. Do you know what I mean?
He's tough.
I knew MTK signed him. I knew he was a good one, you know. But I just, when I started there, working, the pop shots, pop, which I should have been doing early. He had no engine. Like, he was strong, typical strong. And he came back, and I said, Jesus. I was only educated pressure, just break him down slowly.
Mm.
And I started working. I should have done that earlier on, but.
You said that you changed the game plan mid-fight, which was working, sitting on his chest.
Yeah,
and
yeah.
So what was the game plan going in?
The game plan was, because I knew he had that right hand, was to keep blocking the right hand, and then parried him after a half a short fight. But if he was blocking the right hand, he caught me left hook. Do you know what I mean? I forgot about that shot. But then we just changed. No, the flash shot, and it just, that actually helped me, that shot. Just made me dig deep then, you know.
Yeah. I want to touch on the Ray Beltran fight again, because people say styles make fight.
Yeah, two left hooks.
So what is that the fight you think would be fan friendly?
Oh yeah, he has the connection with Top Rank and stuff. Mm-hmm. And Michael coming over to Belfast. Why not? That'd be something now in the future. Why not?
Beltran and Belfast on
Mick. Why not? Like that's what I'm thinking.
Yeah.
You have to think of the wish these things. Down the line, if he wins, if he doesn't win, we go up the rankings, you know what I mean?
Mm-hmm. Well, Stephen, I won't keep you longer. I've just caught you in the shower there. I don't know if you were sitting on the toilet in the shower. What were you doing?
Oh, yeah. I was having a posh shower.
A posh shower. There you go then. Right, Stephen, thanks for the time from TV. No doubt. I'll catch up
soon. Thank you,
right. Cheers, brother.